Remember your wedding day? A couple of years ago now. Your wedding day should be a celebration of love, goodwill, and hope. But thanks to the pandemic, one couple's big day has become a thing of heartbreak.
Yes, because as they and we discovered, when it comes to COVID-19 and contracts, whether between couples or venues, things can get complicated.
So what do you do when everyone is trying to protect themselves? Jill investigates.
Meet Scout.
He's very special. He's the apple of our eye and our firstborn.
So who's better to be ring bearer for Jordan and Emma's wedding on April the 4th?
We had to have a place that could have him.
And they found just the spot.
Quite liked the
rustic feel.
Yeah, the rustic kind of feel.
But while the couple are thankfully still in love, there's been a fallout with the venue.
We still like the location. We like the outdoors and we like the inside, but yeah, the feeling for the venue is not a happy one.
Why is that?
COVID cancelled our wedding, we were keen to reschedule a wedding, but then we've lost our money.
The venue owners, who won't go on camera, say it's not lost. They're just keeping what they believe is a fair and reasonable amount. It was all so different when preparations first began. There was excitement about the dress.
Oh, it feels like wedding time.
About having found a good catch.
Someone kind and trustworthy.
It was all falling into place for Emma, an intensive care nurse, and Jordan, who works for defence.
It's been a long time coming.
But they hadn't counted on COVID-19, which spelled curtains for their wedding day. So Jordan's parents gave them this space so they could store all the alcohol, flowers, and decorations they pulled together.
We're saving for two and a half years, yeah.
And most suppliers were happy to hold deposits for any new date.
We didn't take any money back from them. We just asked to hold it in a credit because we still want to use them.
But the venue set conditions that took the couple by surprise. Having paid $6,500 to the venue, they were given four options before level 4 lockdown. One, reschedule within 6 months of March the 15th with no money lost. Two, reschedule for later than 6 months but before year's end and lose 50% of their deposit. Three, rebook same time next year, but lose 100% of their deposit. Or they could cancel altogether, losing the venue and their money.
We think it's unfair because we've got nothing for our money at this point in time.
It might be hard to recall now, but working in intensive care as lockdown began was a frightening time. The couple were playing it so safe, they weren't even living in the same house. So the thought of a wedding before the year was out of the question.
I didn't think that it was ethically responsible.
Never mind the nightmare for friends and family from overseas if borders stay closed.
Basically, we needed to forfeit our money. When I said that didn't really fit for us, then the manager put the pressure on.
But the venue owners see things very differently. They're a family business. They've been hit really hard by the fallout from the pandemic. And their understanding was that the deposit was there to help with ongoing costs.
So while the rest of the world ground to a halt, both sides were busy seeking legal advice. Concessions were made about rescheduling, the venue saying they could keep the deposit to use in 2021, but the couple says it was too little, too late.
If we had had a little bit of negotiation at the start, then we would have rebooked with them, but after 5 weeks and two lawyers kind of backwards and forwards, that it's just gone for us.
With no agreement, they had what's called a frustrated contract. It's when something happens, in this case COVID-19, that means the event gets cancelled through no fault of either party.
The normal rules contained in that contract for cancellation don't apply. The contract is at an end. Whatever their terms are for cancellation or refunds, they don't exist. What exists is the act. Interpreted in favour of the
That's company. The Contracts and Commercial Law Act, which says the customer gets a full refund, although the venue can keep expenses related to the event, but
it's only reasonable expenses that should be retained. This is the thing, isn't it? What are reasonable costs? In this case, reasonable costs would be things that have actually been incurred and incurred specifically for the wedding that was to proceed on the 4th of April. So things like buying food for that wedding,
But the venue says their legal advice was that reasonable costs included wages, ACC fees, bank charges, grounds maintenance, licenses, power, gas, rent, rates, building repairs, telephone charges, and computer consumables, which is why they felt okay keeping the deposit, at first the whole amount, but then the owners offered to split halfway, $3,250 each.
So given they offered you half, why do you still think that that's unfair?
None of those costs really attributed to fulfilling our contract.
It's worth noting the law says the venue can't just come up with a figure. They have to prove any expenses are for running the event.
All of those things are just expenses associated with the running of their business generally. So therefore, applying logic and reasoning and the legal test, I would say that they are not reasonable expenses.
COVID-19 has meant concerts, matches and kids' sport club memberships have all been cancelled. This lawyer experienced all of these firsthand, always scoring a full refund.
None of those instances did we get a letter coming to us saying, oh look, you know, you've got to pay a share of the overhead. So I really don't see why wedding venues are any different.
We understand they're a business and it's a really rough time for them. Everyone's got their own stuff going on and you just have to work together.
The venue says it's been more than generous, but the couple feel let down. So instead of sharing a happy wedding day, they've agreed to meet at the Disputes Tribunal.
It turns what should be a happy, fun, loving experience into something that's negative.
I really do feel for them.
They are ready to get married. The dog is ready to carry the ring down the aisle. Anyway, Jordan and Emma will be joined at the Disputes Tribunal by two other couples also fighting the same venue for their deposit.
Now, you might have noticed we've taken the unusual step of not naming the place because these are unusual times. And like many small businesses, this venue is struggling due to COVID-19.
But that does not mean we're giving them a free pass. We still believe it is extremely unfair for them to hold on to deposits, especially for events that get cancelled. We really hope that they change their tune.
That's right.